This video explains how to set up the calculation of how the chemical potential of a solvent or a solute in a liquid mixture changes with concentration. Okay, what we've studied in the prior video is how the chemical potential of a gas changes with concentration. And this is the expression that we have found out. Now, the gas phase is interesting, but of course the solution phase is much more interesting because that's where more chemical reactions in the life sciences take place. Okay, so our question is going to be how we can write an expression like this, but then for a solute or a solvent that is here in the solution phase. Okay, the way that we're actually going to do this is by trying to mirror this chemical potential of the gas to the chemical potential in the liquid, and we're going to do that by trying to see how these two phases are related. Okay, alright, so let's assume that we can calculate here the mole Gibbs energy of this particular configuration right here. Okay, where you only have liquid A in the gas in the solution phase, and then gas A. The total Gibbs energy is going to be equal to the number of moles of A that you have in the gas phase times the chemical potential of A in the gas phase. Okay, plus the number of moles that you have of A in the liquid phase multiplied by the chemical potential of A in the liquid phase. Okay, that will give you the total Gibbs energy of this configuration. Now let's assume that a tiny little bit of A goes into the gas phase. And this tiny little bit of A is just going to be a differential of N, an infinitesimal amount of moles. What will happen to the mole Gibbs energy after this infinitesimal step has taken place? Well, what we'll have is that the amount of moles of A in the gas phase has increased by a little bit. Right, so this is going to be equal to NA in the gas plus differential of N multiplied by the chemical potential of A in the gas. And then we'll have that the number of moles of A in the liquid phase has decreased by a little bit. Okay, so that would be N sub A of the liquid minus differential of N multiplied by the chemical potential of A in the liquid. Okay, if we can calculate if we were to calculate what the change in the Gibbs energy is by subtracting initial from final, then what we will get is that this is equal to differential of N and then common factor of the difference in chemical potentials between the gas and the liquid phase. Okay. Now, we're always going to be working at situations in which we have equilibrium between the phases. Okay, so what that means is that this is going to be equal to zero. Okay, if we're at equilibrium. And the only way that this can take place is if the parenthesis is zero. Right? So it turns out that for a situation of equilibrium, what you need to have is that the chemical potential in the gas phase has to be identical to the chemical potential in the liquid phase. Okay, and that's actually great, because then we can actually rewrite the chemical potential of the liquid phase using that expression for the gas phase. Again, if we're at equilibrium, then none of the two phases pushes the other harder or the other way around, right? They both have the same chemical potential, they're in a situation of equilibrium, okay? And again, if these two things are exactly the same at equilibrium, then what that means is that we can actually rewrite this as now dependent on the liquid, right? So this, at equilibrium, is going to be exactly the same as the chemical potential of the liquid, okay? Right, so this is our starting point. And of course, we're going to have to modify a little bit this expression because we have the following problem. Notice that we're trying to express here the chemical potential of the liquid, but here we're using a property that depends on the gas, and that's a little awkward. What we would like to do is express the chemical potential of the liquid on a property that depends on the concentration of A in the liquid. And that could be molarity, or perhaps mole fraction, or molality, or again, a measure of concentration in the liquid phase, not in the gas phase. Okay, so we will be able to do that using something that is called Raoult's law, which is explained in the next video.